Hollywood or a guest.
Hello, Mrs. Pingleton.
And you, Penny?
Hello, Mrs. Pingleton. I mean, Mother.
Teenagers, they just love watching that corny Collins. Color. The TV is black and white.
We have to steer them in the right direction. I mean, you know what I mean. Hey, Amber, I've got something for you. I figured, since we've been going together sort of steadily, maybe we should make it official.
Oh my gosh, Link, your council member ring, how sweet. And it matches my hair color, exactly.
None of that. Take it personalized for the camera, and we're back. In 5, 4, 3! Now don't forget, guys and gadgets, our very first primetime spectacular is coming up on June 1st. We'll be live in Baltimore's brand new auditorium, broadcasting nationwide. Talent scouts will be on hand from all the major record labels, and sponsoring the event will be none other than our very own Ultra Clutch Hairspray! So let's give a great big fawning Baltimore salute to the president of Ultra Clutch, Harriman F. Spritzer!
Ultra Clutch is happy to bring you fine youngsters to national attention.
Hooray!
Also on the special, we'll be crowning your choice of this teenage hairspray, 1962.
My big break!
Well, isn't she a lovely slim girl?
Well, I guess Amber's pretty, but she can't dance.
Plastic little spastic.
Oh my god, I'm gonna kill myself! Look, she's wearing Lee Blackman's council ring!
Hey gang, don't forget to watch Mom and Me next Thursday on Mother-Daughter Day. And I wanted your next teenage hairspray. Remember, a vote for me from you is a vote for me.
What an unexpected ad-lib, Amber. And speaking of expecting the unexpected, our very own fun-loving, freewheeling Brenda will be taking a temporary leave of absence from the show. How long will you be gone, Brenda?
9 months.
Well, it seems like we'll have an opening for a girl who's just as fun-loving. Maybe not quite as freewheeling. Want to be one of the nicest kids in town? Come on down to station WZZT to audition.
Oh my god, it's a dream of a lifetime. I have to go audition.
Oh my god, it's a dream of a lifetime. I have to go watch you audition.
That'll be enough of that for one day.
No one is auditioning for anything. There'll be no cutting school in this house.
But this is true, Black.
Penny, don't tell your mother she wants you.
She does?
floating bubblegum business downstairs is booming. How am I too funny, honey?
Oh, stop, Wilbur, you're the funny one. Daddy, tomorrow I'm going to audition for a television show.
You're going to have to go further than that to get around me, young lady.
No one is auditioning for anything. And what did I tell you about the hair? All ratted up like a teenage Jezebel.
Oh, Mother, you're so 50s. Even our First Lady, Jackie B. Kennedy, rats her hair.
Well, you ain't no First Lady, are you?
She's a hair hopper. That's what she is. And I gotta put in detention. Again. Wilbur, talk to her. Girls like us, people like Tracy, you know what I'm saying? They don't put people like us on television except to be laughed at. It's my dream, Daddy.
Then you go for it. This is America, babe. You gotta think big to be big.
Being big is not the problem, Wilbur.
When I was your age, my parents begged me to run away with the circus. But I said, no, that's what you want. I've got dreams of my own. I dreamt of opening a chain of dope shops worldwide. So, okay, I still only have one. If I can figure out how to keep the air from leaking out of my sofa-sized whoopee cushion, I'm going to make a noise heard around the world! You follow your dream, baby. I'm grabbing an orange crush and heading back down to the hearty heart. You got my dream. And I love it!
Wilbur, you're not helping. Thanks, Daddy. Tracy, come back up here. I've got hampers of laundry and my diet pill is wearing off.
But, Mama, I want to be famous.
You want to be famous? Learn how to get blood out of car upholstery. Now that's a skill you could take right to the bank. You think I wanted to spend my life washing and mending other people's clothing? No, I wanted to design them.
I thought I'd be the biggest thing in brassieres.
Well, you better be careful what you wish for. Now start folding.
Ugh. But all I was doing was watching Courtney Collins over at Tracy's.
Didn't I forbid you from listening to race music? Oh, if the police ever find your father, he'll punish you good.
Your dancing was atrocious today, Amber. I'm willing to lie, cheat, and steal to win you that Miss Hairspray crown, but you have got to work with me. Ugh, no wonder that's it.
Ugh, stop. That's no way to treat clean clothes. One day, you'll own Edna's Occidental Laundry. Will you be ready?
I hope not.
Don't contradict me.
Don't disobey.
Don't even think about going to that audition.
Please.
No.
Mother. Stop.
Stop telling me what to do.
Don't
treat me like a child of two.
No.
I know that you want what's best.
Please.
But mother, please.
Stop.
Don't know. Please. Stop. Don't know. Please. Mama, I'm a big girl now. Once upon a time,
My, how this town has gone downhill since I was crowned Miss Baltimore Crabs.
Oh my God, I thought we would never get here!
Stupid bus crash.
All my life, I imagined what this place would look like. This isn't it.
Hi there. Is it too late to audition?
Not too late, dear, just too much.
Tracy, look! It's Link!
Link Larkin. So close and yet so gorgeous.
I know. Those girls were all over me. I don't know how Rock Hudson stands it. Sorry, little darling. Hope I didn't dent your do.
I can hear the bells.
Tracy, are you all right?
Well, don't you hear them chime?
I don't hear anything.
Can't you feel my heart? When he tapped me and knocked me off my feet, one little touch and my life's complete. 'Cause when he nudged me, but put me in a fix, yes, it hit me just like a ton of bricks. Yes, my heart burst, now I know what life's about. One little touch and love's not.
But I screwed the judges of bronze, I think.
Baltimore it isn't.
Where's Courtney? I'd love to dance for him.
I'm the producer. And may I be frank? First impressions can be tough. And when I saw you, I knew it. And your size was enough. Your last game to judge. Of course not. But you can bow and exalt, 'cause I am Miss Baltimore.
Let the doo-doo some dancing.
It's the hottest dance around, and it was going right here in Baltimore. What's it called?
Kid Madison.
And you have to see it first.
The Corny College Show.
Let's make two big strong lines. It's Madison time. Go! By a brand new council member, Tracy Turnbull. Okay. get up your pony and tell us about yourself, Therese.
Well, I go to Patterson Park High, and I watch your television show, and I do absolutely nothing else. But one day I hope to be the first woman president of the world, or Roquette. You have to think big to be big.
And if you were president, what would your first official act be?
Well, I make every day Negro Day.
I'll read you like tomorrow's headline strips. What do you say, kids? We might just have a new candidate for Miss Teenage Hairspray.
No! She can't be Miss Teenage Hairspray. She's the before in the Metrical diet ad, and I'm the after, and afters always win.
Amber, what a comedian. So, Tracy, tell us true. How would you like Link Larkin to sing a song just for you?
No! Link Larkin can't sing to her because everyone knows that when he sings to me. He's completely in love with me.
Right. So, Tracy, tell us true. How would you like Link Larkin to sing a song just for you?
Would I?
You people are ignoring the laws of nature.
Link Larkin, our own budding Elvis, will now sing to the equally blooming Tracy Turnblad his version of the top 40 hit, It Takes Two.
Mother!
Collins
show.
Why not? They do it all the time on Lassie.
Mr. Spritzer, to keep up with the times, you've got to keep up with your audience.
The show's fine the way it is.
Bringing Tracy on is just the beginning. I've got tons of excellent ideas for updating the show.
I'm getting one of my sick headaches. Is there any place where I might lie down?
There's a bed in my office. So, you've got ideas, do you? And bringing on this no-talent commie is one of them?
Damn right, Velma. It's time we put kids on the show that look like the kids that watch the show.
Not while I'm producing it.
I was thinking it might be time to change that, too.
Are you threatening me, Colin?
You know me, Velma. On the other hand, I could have just take the show to Channel 11.
Oh, my God. That snake that sings. He's a puppet, but I hold the purse and the strings. God, I knew Negro Day would bring chaos and change. Now he's pushing this pinko who might give us all mange. She's a blemish, a blackhead that must be expelled. There's a standard of beauty that must be upheld. You can say I'm a bigot, but it just isn't true. Look, I love Sammy Davis, so he's black and Jew.
Yes, and she loves you too, very much, whoever you are. Goodbye. Oh, this is crazy. Hello? What am I wearing? House dress, scuffies, and some hose. What are you wearing? Hello? Hello?
Mama, did you see? Did you see me?
Of course I did. It was on television. I had to. The phone's been ringing like weed was a telethon.
To think, the beloved TV icon, the fruit of my womb.
So you're not mad?
Not mad?
How could I be mad? If only you told me you was going to get on the show, I never would have said you couldn't. But come, sit. Tell me, is fame everything you thought it would be? Are you happy, honey?
Yes, Mama.
And I think I'm in love.
I know, I've been following.
You and I are going to have a little talk about crooners. We can all learn a little from the mistakes of Miss Debbie Reynolds.
And there it goes again. Hello? Yes, this is Tracy Turnblad.
Hello, Mr. Pinky?
Mr. Pinky? As in Mr. Pinky's hefty hide of equality clothes for quantity gals? That Mr. Pinky?
Shh! You want me to be your exclusive fashion effigy and spokesgirl?
What's an effigy? Well, that's very flattering, Mr. Pinky, but I'm afraid that all business must go through my agent. It'll be our pleasure. We'll be right over. Thank you. Goodbye, Mr. Pinky.
An agent? I don't know any agents. How about a nice bail bondsman?
Mother, put that thing down.
I'm going to take my new agent to the Hefty Hideaway and then a night on the town.
Oh, me? Tracy Turnblad, fame has gotten to your head and left you wacky. You need a top shelf professional who handled the divorce sisters.
Well, who didn't?
Mom, there's a great big world out there that I know nothing about. When things get tough, a girl needs her mother.
Hon, I'll be right beside you. That's what you want. And together, we'll claw your way to the top. Can we do it over the phone? I've been at this apartment since Mamie Eisenhower rolled her hose and bumped her bangs.
Yes, I know that the world's spinning fast now. You gotta get yourself a ring.
Sylvester.
Well, Mr. Pinky, you certainly picked a lovely girl to put the pluses in your plus sizes.
Now, Tracy, this can't be your agent. She must be your gorgeous, a big sister.
What, Mr. Pinky? You're twisting my head. I'm not her gorgeous big sister.
I'm 54. Double D.
Triple E.
Oh, mama! Hit the motor. Step inside my arms and let's make a deal.
Hi, Tracy. Sorry about your special edness, but think of it as a testament to the record-breaking. All that chewing must make the muscles in your mouth and vibes swell.
Not really. Probably just average.
Well, well, well. Tracy Tugboat. Finally saw the title you could win.
Miss Special Ed, knock it off, Amber. Amber Von Tussel, you have acne of the soul.
Students! Hey, Dunya guy, dodge this!
You feel like a girl!
Hey, no fear, throw it on the head! Yeah, hit it in the nuts! Everyone take it easy, some rules were free!
Then you! Eat dodgeball, creepy tunnel alert!
Game over! Class is good. Hey, girls, anyone want to take a shower? Extra credit.
Poor Tracy. So tragic.
I forgot to cry.
Are you coming, Link?
Amber, that wasn't necessary.
I said, are you coming, Link?
In a minute.
I'll be waiting under the bleacher.
Uh-oh, Tracy, are you dead?
I better go get the school nurse.
I'll go with you.
Tracy, are you okay? Gee, you're beautiful when you're unconscious.
I can hear the bells.
Link, where am I? Gee, you better? For a second, I thought it was Teen Angel time.
Wherever I am, don't change the channel.
You have a funny way of putting things. I like that.
The nurse got sick, but look what Stevie found.
Band-aids. Q-tips, and rubber. Oh, no, sorry, that one's in my
He's so nurturing.
Seaweed, this is Link Larkin. How you doing?
How you doing?
How are you doing?
How do you think? I got creamed in front of the entire school.
Hey, Chase, I don't want to make you feel better. My mom's pitching a platter party at a record shop on North Avenue. Want to come check it out? Oh.
I, too, feel not good. May I also come check it out?
Oh, you surely may.
Well, I've never been to North Avenue before.
Well, would it be safe up there for, you know, us?
Calm down, cocky boy.
It's cool.
What do you think, Link?
I think getting to know you is the beginning of a whole lot of adventure.
Imagine being invited places by colored people.
It feels so hip.
Glad to feel that way, friend. Because not everybody does. Vanilla can be nice, the truth be told, blackberry,
Well, you're the only one who did, because they kicked me out of my young, gifted, and black behind.
Negro Day.
You're gonna crash White Day!
White day is every day. You gotta get more specific than that.
Is tomorrow specific enough? Think, it's mother-daughter day at the studio. Miss Motormouth, you work for the studio. They wouldn't be able to turn you and little Inez away. And once you two break the barrier, we can all dance on TV together.
That thinking is downright revolutionary.
They set off sparks like Rosa Parks.
Child, it ain't that easy. This ain't that cheesy. And what if they call the cops? Someone could get hurt.
Then we'll walk out together. There's me, there's Link, and there's the others. Without dancers, they've got no show.
You got that right.
Well, what a decision. Your girl's got vision.
Well, we're certainly trying to teach her to do what's right.
And give her a change.
Tracy, you can't do this. You're new to the council. You'll be blackballed and thrown off the show for sure. Well, that's why we're all going to do it together. Not me. You don't think segregation is wrong? Look, I like these people, but whether they're on TV or not, it's going to give me a recording contract. That came out wrong. Look, I've been singing and dancing and smiling on that show for 3 years, waiting for it to lead to my big break. You have everything. Brains, talent, personality. Me, I have one chance to be seen nationwide. Tracy's Saturday Night is everything I've been working for. I'm not going to throw it all away. Come on, I'm leaving and you gotta go too. No! I want to do this and so should you. It's what's right. Link, stay, please.
Sorry.
But you and me, I was just starting to think. Yeah, so was I.
But I don't know. Things are getting too complicated and there's still Amber. See you, little darling.
I'm sorry, Tracy.
Oh, Mama, how could I think that a boy like Link Larkin would ever like a girl like me?
Why wouldn't he? You're a beautiful girl. It's just Eddie Fisher all over again.
Don't tease, Mama. I really liked him.
I know you did, and he probably likes you too. It's just boys are not the smartest things. So, you give him some time. I'm sure he'll figure out he's crazy about you.
You have to say that. You're my mother.
I'm more than your mother. I'm a woman in love, and we know about the stuff.
But, Tracy, he could be right. Should you risk your career?
I never would have gotten on the show if it wasn't for Seaweed. No, it's payback time.
That's my girl.
Okay, this is how we're gonna do it. Tomorrow, everybody bring your mothers.
And sisters!
And meet around the corner and paint signs.
And put words on them!
Miss Motormouth, you and the Lioness will go first. Mama and I will be right behind you.
Oh, excuse me?
Well, we'll never be able to push them out the door with us blocking it.
I'm sorry, Tracy, but no one said anything about me appearing on television. I'm sorry, but I simply cannot appear on television at my present weight.
You can't let weight restrict your fame. Look at me. I'm on TV.
But, Miss Motormouth, you're a celebrity. Well, I'm just a simple housewife of indeterminate girth.
The bigger the girth, the more you're worth. Mr. Turnblad, you don't mind if the missus here's an ample American, do you?
Not at all. I think of her as prime real estate.
Yeah, nice and roomy. Now you listen to me.
Once upon a time, girl, I was just like you. Never let my extra large lock just shine through. Hair was brown and nappy, never had no fun. I hid under a bushel, which is easier said than done. Then one day my grandma